You may not know it, but right now off the east coast of Aotearoa New Zealand's North Island, scientists from all over the world are studying something called the Hikurangi Subduction Zone.
The Hikurangi Subduction Zone is one of the major plate boundaries in New Zealand, and it's mostly focused in the North Island, and it's where the Pacific Plate is basically diving down westward beneath the eastern part of the North Island.
The Hikurangi Subduction Zone is Aotearoa New Zealand's largest and most active fault, running offshore from Gisborne down to the top of the South Island. Recent science suggests that the likelihood of a Hikurangi fault rupture may be higher than initially understood.
Has already engulfed some cities. Fires breaking out due to the earthquake. In northeastern Japan's Iwate Prefecture, tsunami waves of over 4 meters were observed soon after the quake. The agency is warning that...
We now know that Hikurangi Subduction Zone earthquake and tsunami has the potential to be similar to the tsunami in Japan in 2011. The reality is, it's not a matter of if, but when.
Live coverage from our helicopter up in northern Miyagi Prefecture, where a tsunami obviously coming in several sweeps.
East Coast Life of the Boundary is a project that brings together scientists, emergency managers, and other experts from across the East Coast to make it easy and exciting to learn more about natural hazards and how they can affect us. We're working together with Civil Defence, Emergency Services, and many other organisations to develop and test the Hikurangi Response Plan.
Matauranga Māori speaks of large tsunamis, and since written records began, Aotearoa New Zealand has been impacted by 10 tsunamis higher than 5 metres. In 1947, Gisborne experienced a tsunami that was up to 10 metres high in some locations.
So the Hikurangi Subduction Zone has actually generated earthquakes in the past. The largest one in the historical record were in 1947. There were actually two earthquakes generated on the Subduction Zone in March and May of 1947, offshore of Gisborne. And these weren't particularly large in the scheme of things. They were only about a magnitude 7.2. They weren't magnitude 8 or magnitude 9, but they did actually cause quite large tsunami for the size of the earthquake, given what we'd expect that size of earthquake to cause.
We know a large earthquake and tsunami is something we will face in our lifetime or that of our children and grandchildren. Emergency managers are planning for it, but how prepared are you? Everyone must prepare because we are all part of civil defence.
What people really can do to be prepared for this is to make sure that, you know, A, if there's a tsunami, that they know their evacuation route and they can get to higher ground very quickly. And then B, have a plan with their family to meet back up with their families and make sure everyone in their family knows what to do in the event of an earthquake or tsunami. And C, make sure that they're prepared to survive at home with enough food and water until things get back on track.
All this may sound overwhelming, but we must all know what to do. Practice your drop, cover and hold and tsunami hikoi to high ground or inland by foot or bike. We know practicing these two things works, as it helped save over 95% of people's lives in Japan in 2011 that safely evacuated in time. Remember, if it's long or strong, get gone. You can find out more about preparation and planning at www.happens.nz. And you can check your tsunami evacuation zones on your local Civil Defence Group website.